Today's video is about the most common problem of the females, that is PCOS. The patient is 32 years of age with advanced case of known PCOS disease. She is very stressed, she is overweight and has primary infertility. Some treatment plans will be discussed after the ultrasound scan. This is the TVS ultrasound of the patient. Uterus is visualized. Uterus is normal in size, 7.9 cm. No mass or no fibroid is seen. The endometrium is thin, 5.5 mm. This is due to long amenorrheas and medicine intakes. Now the right ovary is visualized. We can see that ovary is large and elongated. Its size is 57 mm. Normal this is less than 45 mm. The largest follicle is 7 mm in the ovary. This is 12th day scan for the follicles, but we don't see any growing or dominant follicle in the ovary. There are multiple small follicles in the ovary, mostly are peripheral placed. These are plus 25 in number and size approximate 2 to 5 mm. Now the left ovary is visualized. Left ovary is also enlarged. This is also elongated. Size of the ovary is 55 mm. Normal this is less than 45 mm of size. The largest follicle in the ovary is 14 multiply 11 mm. This is not a good follicle at 12 day. This is mild elongated and mild irregular valve. No other growing or no other dominant follicle seen in the ovary. This ovary is also contains multiple small follicles that are at least plus 25 in number, of size 3 to 5 mm. So we have seen that this patient has gross polycystic ovary disease, and although she is taking medications, there are no signs of any good or dominant follicle for ovulation. So the medications alone are not causing any improvement in the patient. Now what are the important causes of PCOS? The first is insulin resistance that occurs in more than 70% of all the cases. This causes increase in weight. The second is the excess androgens the ovaries produce. The third cause is family history or PCOS. These three causes are interlinked with each other. The fourth cause is adrenal PCOS that occurs during massive stressful period. And the fifth cause is post-pill PCOS that occurs after stopping the intake of oral contraceptive pills. Now the most important part is the discussion of the treatment. The two most important things we see from the causes are stress causing PCOS and insulin resistance overweight linked with hormonal imbalance and excess androgen produced by the ovary. We all know about this. And in every videos and every doctor says to the patient, reduce stress and reduce the weight. But how this is possible? A person that is in severe stress, for example, serious family problem or having an exam after 1 week, how can she reduce stress by pushing a button in the body and the stress disappears? Similarly, the weight reduction in PCOS patient is very difficult. They try to lose weight, but the weight is not reduced and the patient is totally disappointed. And this increases more stress and PCOS disease becomes severe. So we can say that directly reduction in the stress and immediate weight reduction is not possible. First is the brisk walk 3 km daily. This is the most important point. The walk with intense sweating reduces the stress of the patient no matter what are the problems. It also helps to regularize the various hormonal systems of the body. Second is the changing of lifestyle of the eating without thinking of weight reduction. The weight reduction occurs slowly after 5 to 6 months. Completely quit all the foods containing sugar and completely quit foods taking from bazaar or factory made and all the fast foods. After that, maximum reduce your roti, bread or rice intake daily. You can take half roti morning or half roti evening. The aim is to maximum reduce carbohydrate intake daily. Eat diet rich in protein. Make a list of high protein diets that you can eat. And every time you feel hungry, eat something from that list. Some high protein diet foods are written in the video. Gross and advanced cases of the PCOS are destroying the lives of the females. And if you make these two changes in your life, you will see changes in your body gradually. And then medications also help to develop a good follicle, and many patients with advanced PCOS disease was able to conceive.